I've been here for the last 50 years. So I just couldn't recognize anybody. The same way I suppose for others also. And it's good now that we have met each other, our wives have met each other, and we can proceed further to relive those days for the next 20 or 30 years. God be with you. Thank you very much. And then now I'll leave it back to the master of ceremony to proceed further.
Next on the agenda, the mic will be given to each one of the members. And they will give a short synopsis of what their experience in school.
3 minutes. Good afternoon, everyone. I am Herman Johnson from E Road.
Sir, please keep the mic close. On.
Hello.
Please hold it like this. Keep it here.
Hello. Yes. Now we can hear. Hello. I am Herman Johnson from E Road, but at present based in Bangalore. Right. I am from this 1969 batch, and most of my friends here at that time we were teenagers, and I recognized them well. But today I am at 0% in recognizing one and all because we are senior citizens. I was a sportsman for our school, and I represented the school at the state level where I won gold medals in the 100 meters and long jump, which I have certificates and I brought it along. I was running my school with hockey, playing the state level. And to go to state level, we have to represent the district and division and then state. So I went through all that. But when most of my friends who were in the sports team, a few of them have expired, which pained my heart because I knew them so well. And in memory of them, I've written a poem which I will read out to you. Right. That to remind everyone that we will meet them one day. My poem means that we will go and meet them one day. And again, we form up a COPA 1969 team then. My voice is loud, so I can read it out. So I wrote the poem, I gave it to the departed souls of COPA 1969. A time will come when we all must die, requesting our loved ones never to cry. Our souls will be, our bodies will be, our souls will cry towards the universe above the sky. No one knows where's heaven or hell. The God of death is the one can tell. He guides the soul from the earth so well, sending the good to heaven and the bad to hell. Some depart early, some depart late. Greed of this body is the poor soul's fate. They are judged as per their earthly needs. For heaven or hell is the reward's the key. Life on earth is a meaningless lot. Try for good things at this earthly cost. Eternal life is for centuries to gain, till reincarnation occurs again. This I wrote in memory of our with us, and I expected the boys who were with me in the team, few are not here, but Aziz Zula was the one who accompanied me to Delhi when we represented Tamil Nadu at the Republic Day parade, and we stood first in the whole So the time for 3 minutes is quite short. I can go on.
No, actually you got some more time later.
I thank you all for coming, because the core team that sits here has really strived hard to get your all together. And thank you once more for being here. I hope you like my home for the departed soul.
Thank you, Raman. Next, Chino will speak to you.
Earlier, when we started this, there's kind of apprehensive about who will come and who will not. When I heard guys are coming from Australia and other places far away, Jaipur and all that, I was really happy. So this cannot happen otherwise. It's a reunion. And I am very immensely happy, and I hope you also enjoy the whole day to your satisfaction. And now, I want each of you to stand up, introduce your spouse, your children, your grandchildren, and tell us what you're doing. Not elaborate, but just what you're doing. You're retired, say you're retired. Most of us are going to say that. Okay? So let's start.
Good. Manika. Manika, wait. Sitaram will be the departed brothers, fathers, and the students. Please feel the name.
Sober homage to those who made us stand tall, walk and run the race of life. Reverend Father A.J. Thambi, Reverend Father T.M. Mathai, Reverend Father Griffin, Reverend Father Hessin, Reverend Father Jarvis Melakal, and our staff teachers, Mr. A. Ramakrishna Rao, Mr. J. Thomas, Mr. J. Nanapennu, Mr. D. Tennyson, Mr. V. Aloghaswamy, Mr. D. S. Manuel, Mr. A. Jesudas, Mr. I. Ratnaswamy, and in our younger stage, 6th and 5th standard, Ms. Jeremiah, Ms. Dylan, Ms. Pinto, and Ms. Smith.
Students.
Okay. So more homage to those who were beside us. These guys sat next to us, befriended us, quarreled with us, loved us, and above all, they made us friends all through school. S. Ramamurthy, Abdul Hadi, V. Lalchand, T. Kishore, T. J. Nadan, A. Bashir Ahmed, R. Thirumalai, P. Vijay Raghavan, R. Srinivasan, K. Gunasekaran, Joseph A. Rajkumar, B. Vivekananda Prabhu, Kevin Rosario, N. Vikraman.
I am Tony Martin. After leaving school in 69, I finished my BA in St. Joseph's College, Trichy, and then joined the railway. Retired as a mail and express guard, now enjoying retired life with a good pension. So I am happy. I got a nice wife.
Actually,
what I am, you may say it's Campion, but I can say it's my wife. I've got three sons, two in Australia, one in Melbourne, one in Brisbane, and one son in Chennai, in IndusInd Bank. And I'm very happy. And the most thing in my life is I can turn back and say it's Campion. Thank you.
Thank you.
And I think I have not taken more than 3 minutes. So I hand over the mic to the next person.
Very nice.
My name is Arunachalam. After school, I went to St. Joseph's College for pre-university and Madras Rehanda College for commerce. I went to UK for doing law and practicing law in Malaysia. Still practicing, not perfect yet. So it will take some time, I suppose. I like to hear our friend says he's retired, not retarded. So it's good. And he's from Campion and his wife is his champion. That's my wife. And we have the 4 kids. The first of 3 are actually triplets. The triplets, 2 boys and a girl. Girls in Singapore, 1 boy in Singapore, 1 boy is in the US. And the 4th one is also a boy in Singapore. So we are in Malaysia.
Take how much time you want, like a load to talk.
So that's for myself. Thank you.
Good afternoon. My name is Aziz Ullah. I am better known as Aziz. I am a hotelier. I am not retired. I don't know how many more years I am going to work, but it's all God's will. We are standing here before you because of that man, Mr. Denison. He made us, when we stepped into Campion, we were just expecting to be a good student. Hello, Mani, how are you, Mani? But that person made us what we are today. He first made us a sports person, then we went into the games, and then we made brought laurel to Campion. When Herman, myself, and Martin Selvam attended the Republic Day parade, I don't know which year it was.
1968.
Yes, now we are standing before you, and this is a short history of me, that's all.
Thank you.
I'm married, and my wife's headmistress at Tempark Electronics Limited in Bangalore, where she teaches, and now she's retired and takes care of the poor, orphanages, and aged people. I also do my part at Chennai as well as Bangalore, and we go to the people, the same, this one up, stepping up, doing social work to the poor and the needy. This has been taught to us through our school, Campion High School, where from the bottom of the thing we used to study and we used to be guided. As Azizullah has told, Mr. Denison has played a very, very vital part in my life to make me a state sportsman at the India level. Where I got medals, where I got gold medals, I got certificates, everything to prove it. I brought it with me. I'm sorry I've not brought it on in the room. It's just there. My wife is MABA. Though she has studied in Tamil Nadu, she has headed the school in a Karnataka, separate state. And we are living happily. I have two sons. One is in the US, one is here in India. The one in India was in the US, but he refused to go back, stating that he wants to look after his aged parents. I don't call myself aged, I did it. And I'm still working and heading a logistics thing for Pan India. Throughout India, I travel. And my organization, that is IFB, Industry Indian Fine Banking, it was a multinational with Bosch Germany. We are separated, and we are an Indian company, and they yet keep me only as a consultancy to guide the people and gain on the logistics. That's all. Thank you a lot.
Thank you.
I was a very good football player. Today, I'm a man because of a great man, Mr. Denison. I should be a gangster, but he brought me out. He came to school. He has taken us up for 8 years. From him, I learned a lot of techniques. And today, I'm being considered one of the best coaches in India because of him. And he is the one who taught me Varma and his brother. That technique we are sharing and doing a lot of things. And now still I'm producing. And this is the first time that South Indians have won medals in pro events. Now, two of my girls have won the nationals, discus and javelin. In discus, we have won gold and silver. And javelin won a silver, and my hammer thrower has done gold medalist in the nationals. The art was just from me. And Campion was a place where I was made a man because I was a football player. Because that day only for Thambi called me, what happened to this one? I was not come to class for more than 1 month. Only Denison came and saw my grandmother, brought me to the school there and said, Father, Father called me, yes, hey, what happened? Tomorrow you have to play football, you have to go, because you're not there, anything. Then he said, one who whacked me like anything in the sink around there, and I was staying in his house more than 8 years without doing anything. He made me mad. Today was a thing about him only. That's how to sit here. I am in contact with his family and his son also. I got my wife, his housewife, my daughter is in Seattle, and my son is in Madras with me. Now I'm coaching and producing athletes. And I was happy today morning also, I was there. My boys were wondering the veterans also, under 14, 13. And we have a lot of athletes. And it was happy because I'm here, mainly because of Mama. Because I was held up and had a lot of problems. Every good operation I came here because of Monica and Meenakshi, you white with me. I was very happy to see you all. I feel proud of you. Thank you very much.
So many years have passed, but these few years, this 63 to 69 stays there. That's why we are all here. And this place only is so comfortable. And I want you all to call me Dad. No one calls me Dad. No one calls me beyond me. So now, then after school, I was at Chino and St. Joseph's.
Yes, sir.
Then I got a MFA degree in KMC. Then I was working in a village, government hospitals. Then I went over to postgraduate. Then I was serving for another 15, 20 years. After 25 years, I gave all the retirement. I am now practicing as a pediatrician in Chennai.
But name of the hospital?
I am not working in the hospital.
Right.
Where is your clinic?
My clinic is in 9 hours. And my house is in Nangambakkam. Please, I'm so thankful to Meenakshi, Sitaram, everyone, I cannot name. They have made this happen. I'm so, I don't know what to say. So,
thank you. Thank you, Padu. Thank you, Padu. அவங்களே திருப்பி போட்டு மணிக்க அவங்களும் உட்கார்
But I am helping my son till today in his business. I have one son and one daughter, and she is in Coimbatore. She is having two children. I don't have anything to tell more because I have not been able to do extra curriculum.
Thank you.
I have a son, and I'm searching for a girl.
So
when I get a girl, I just give it to
you. Very good.
Sorry.
One additional message for Balasubramanian, MBA. When we were the 11th, we were the first one and the only one to organize two meetings. One was Father Reverend Father Tappi sent up, and another one our 695 sent up. In all those things, Mani was a key person. He helped me. Though I organized this, Mani was begin me to do all those things. So at this juncture, I thank Mani for all he has done to us. Though he's not a sportsman, he has done a lot building our 11th standard.
Even I don't remember, but you made it
Monica, next Monica.
Everybody knows my name is Manikam. My wife is Jayanti.
Please come to the stage. Wait, Manikam.
And my daughter has come, and my granddaughter and my grandson.
Come, please, all of them.
Lucky guy, you got everyone with you.
Yes, I also wish to say he is lucky.
blessed with one son and daughter. My son is in US and my daughter is here. She finished her ACS law and she is working in Cambridge Medical Hospital and giving tuition to the taking classes to the CF. I am not a good sportsman, but I am a writer. Ask government.
But a good businessman.
I am a well wisher.
I'm a
social worker.
And I am supported as a law. Don't remember that.
I am not a good man, Mr. Jenny Chan, Mr. Ratan Swami. I am very much attached to Mr. Ratan Swami.
Yes.
And this time, Meenachi is not here. All this, everything was done by Meenachi. Just I just began Meenachi. And Arun, Mr. Sitaraman, Arun Johnson, all of us all get together and we have done it successfully. Thank you very much for the people who come from the real world. We have taken long trip from Australia and Mr. Philip Thomas from Bangalore. Take him. No, I am seeing after you after 50 years.
That is true.
After 50 years, I am seeing you. And Napoleon. Napoleon tumbled in his life and tumbled out of it. So much of suffering, still he has come. It is because of myself and Meenachi. He went to everyone from Nixon. Please come. But somewhat the only poor thing. I don't know why you people are not turned up. Okay, thank you very much.
Thank you.
Next year,
we
come.
Last
year. Then ask Kadesh. Kadesh from Tengasi.
Good afternoon. Kadesh from Tengasi. I did the college after college. I stopped at the whole package. I was supposed to be in Kerala. Then I have two daughters, little daughters, also. Second daughter is in Kadesh. Second daughter is in Muscat, second daughter is in London. And sorry to say, by 2016, my wife passed away. I am with you. Let the grass in the body. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
I am Bernard Gabriel from Tamaram. And so nice to see all my old friends. Maybe I was not able to remember the names, but still we caught up with one and all. And I'm very happy that we made it. Sorry, my wife planned to come, but she couldn't go. She had to go to US for her niece's wedding. I have two sons, one is a doctor and an engineer, both married. My daughter's son has a 8-month-old daughter. Well, I retired in 2013. I joined the Air Force, served 21 years, and I joined State Bank of India for 19 years, so total 40 years service. Retired and spending my happy retired life after 2013. My wife is a retired PG English teacher from government school. So I don't have anything else to say about sports life and all this. So it's been a very great pleasure to be among you all. Thank you one and all, and more especially for the organizers.
Thank you,
who made this a success.
Thank you.
Welcome, my dear friends. Jai Karan, but nowadays people call me James for whatever reason. I think just like to say a little bit about my experience in school. I don't know if anyone joined school in 1961. Anyone from here? 1961. Okay, so I joined school in 1961. Yeah. So I used to keep crying all the time. At the age of 7, I think my parents left me in school with my elder brother. And my early memories of school are not so good. Always crying, always felt hungry, always felt bullied, like in a big herd. We used to sleep in a dormitory for 100 people, in 2-3 rows, a lot of bed bugs. And know if you remember, we used to take
Okay,
but little later, as things, we grew, became teenagers, and life got better and better. And some of those fathers over there left a deep impression. One was Father Merrifield, of course. Father Merrifield. He used to have the tuck box or pocket money, 10 rupees a term. The pocket money, and he kept very good accounts. And 5:30, I think, every morning, he would come and clap and wake us up. Very nice.
Jump up.
Yes.
Yes, jump up.
I remember this Father Kuchiparambal. He was very much into teaching us Shakespeare. So I remember the Midsummer Night's Dream and the Twelfth Night. And I think that set me on a little bit of a journey. Philip Thomas over there and I. Yeah, Philip was a brilliant drummer in the university.
And yeah. JK is a song theater person.
Yeah, I used to do a lot of theater. So thanks to those priests over there. But Father Kunji Parambal is not there.
He's not
in that picture. Okay, so what else I remember? I remember Father Tambi, a very big SCC,
yes,
cadet corps,
with
a big mast and a lot of ropes and ladders, and I can still see that in that big open auditorium. Yeah, who else do I remember? I remember a very brilliant, very nice person, Lord of Spini.
Master Singh.
Okay, so that was school. After school, I was in Loyola College for 1 year. Then I went to a place called Bits Tilani in Rajasthan. I had some people from Jaipur. Philip and I were together for maybe five years or more. I did a master's in management studies. And then after that, I was mostly involved with family business.
Tell your family thing. Kodakanal.
Kodakanal, but I had nothing to do with that. I was making non-ferrous metal powders, which they use for rockets, Pumba and all those, you know, papaya crackers. That was a different kind of a life. Nothing to do with the traditional buses and all this. But after that, I got bitten by what was known as the environment bug. You know, in college, we were very active in the national service scheme. I remember going on camels in the deserts in Rajasthan, trying to plant trees. And that also carried me through. And throughout my life, I've been mostly connected with environmental activism, you can call it. We were a lot into tree planting, fighting the government, taking them to court. And that led me into another avenue in my life. I got involved in what was known as organic farming. For the last 30 years, I've been doing organic farming, a lot of fruit trees, manufacturing, processing, and exporting to Europe. I'm quite active in a kind of organic farming movement called the biodynamic method of farming, which is called spiritual farming. And I am quite deeply involved in this. I'm sorry I haven't brought my wife, I'm separated. But I have two girls, and I handed over my business to them about 15 years ago, and rather early. And I'm now, I say the second innings of my life, the best time of my life has actually started. And it seems to be getting better and better. More active, more running around. I'm a consultant for many organic projects across the world. So I go to China often, I spend 3 to 4 months in there. Malaysia, North Korea. So I have a very exciting life. But I'm really excited. Very, very happy to meet all my classmates. So, Arun, I met in Malaysia. You've got a lovely house, you should visit this day. So, thank you guys.
Yeah, good afternoon. My name is Philip. I reside in Bangalore. And JK and me were together in Bilani. And we knew each other from those days. And we caught up with the Campion life there. Very happy to meet all of you. It was a great pleasure after such a long time meeting everyone. Regarding details about myself, after Campion, I studied in St. Joseph's. After that, I left for Bits Pilani, where I did my engineering. After that, I did my MBA from School of Business Management, Chandigarh. Then I worked for a semiconductor company in Chandigarh for about 8 years. Subsequently, that was during Operation Blue Star. You people may be remembering. Prime Minister Indira Gandhi was assassinated, and it was a big mess. And we were caught up in that because a lot of these Khalistanis and Sardarjis were involved because of the attack on the Golden Temple. So Chandigarh was a beautiful place, it still is, but during those days it became very bad, because we used to have a great life, evening, we used to go till 10:30, 1 o'clock in late evenings and early morning. We used to roam around the entire place having ice creams and things. But then, once all this started, there were, all these army people all around with AK-47s pointed at you, and you had to stop, even though you were in a car, we had to stop every kilometer or so. And you had to get out and open the dicky for them to show, there's nothing there. And it was very bad because we didn't know who was stopping us. It's a very well-planned city. It's a beautiful place. If you get a chance, you people should go and visit Chandigarh, I felt. Now, after I said I worked for a semiconductor company in Chandigarh, subsequently I left them and came down to Bangalore. Now I run a small scale unit. We make pollution control equipment. Specifically, we make electrostatic precipitators and we sell them all over India. We've got some big time people to whom we give on a regular basis. It's a private limited company. My wife and me are directors. She's a homemaker. I've got two children. One of them is a molecular biologist. She's married and she's in Perth, Australia now. My other daughter is an engineer, electronics, and she's working with Nokia software. So this is the broad background. And all that I remember in Campion, of course, apart from the great, the campus and sports and things like that, is I used to stay in Golden Rock, which was about nearly 22 kilometers away from this place. And my younger brother and me, we used to clip it on cycles in those days. And we used to, just enjoy, stopping in between, with some pocket money of 50 paisa, and buying all sorts of snacks and, traveling all over. And 22 kilometers, I wouldn't dream of it now, of course. But then that was great. So we had a good time, I guess. Thank you.
Next, Mr. Napoleon, please.
One second, I forgot to tell something. See, I'm from the army. I fought 2 wars for the country. And as he has mentioned, OP Blue Star, yes, I was present there in Chandigarh during that period where Indira Gandhi was assassinated by her own bodyguard. And it was a tough time. As Philip has rightly said, every step we were ordered to check, because we were fighting against our own people, the Khalistan. Khalistan is Sikhs. They wanted a separate nation. But at last we won. After the death of Bindarwala, they shot him in the Golden Temple and brought his body out. So I was very much present there at that time. And it was actually very, very, very sad that we were fighting against our own people. So just as Philip has highlighted OB Blue Star, yes, I took part in that. I have a certain medal for fighting that war. I have it with me.
Good afternoon, everybody.
I request Mrs. Napoleon also to come.
Please come to the stage.
I'll call her. First, I would like to thank those dinosaurs who planned this I don't think anywhere in this world, leave alone India, school kids meeting after 50 years and this big numbers. Never. Even many schools won't have this. 5 years, 10 years, 15, 20, 25, accepted. 10.
So I will tell you, I am attending it for the second time this year.
Which one?
This 50th.
Okay.
In March, I attended 150th.
50th?
Because I
50th of which one? 1968 batch.
69 batch. Because I joined the school in 69.
Okay.
7.
Yeah.
Before that, I was in Bishop College, Chennai.
Okay.
We celebrated 50 years. We did like the same thing.
In Bishop College?
No, in Bishop Chennai. College. Bishop College High School in Chennai.
Great. I'm not aware.
I cannot keep quiet.
Yes.
Yes. Yes. I wanted to tell you and you already did.
Thank you. Good GK for me. But anyway, it's something very, very new for me. I just couldn't imagine. And that is why I call these people.
Moving into the second. First is my school in Bhiwandi.
Okay. Let us be. It's the silver medal for us.
Yeah.
Okay.
Calm down, Narayan.
Okay. But Meenakshi, Manikam, Omar, and Amitabh, and so Chinu and others, you know, these people took the initiative. And really, they have put things together and we are here today. It's a great thing to see all these young people here. Okay, they are, I won't say old, every day. They are fit enough to come over here, and so I call them young. Okay, and the things which I could remember about Campion first, I would say Father Thambi. He is a person, I was a sportsman,
high jumper,
started my career here only. I never thought I would reach this height. Earlier I was a high jumper here in Campion, later on went on to win college, universities, inter-universities, All India inter-universities, Indian, I was the captain of the Indian and Ceylon, those days, Ceylon combined universities for 2 years, 1973 and 74. Okay, so that was a great thing. I won the Indian Industries Ajaja event also. So it was a lot, way back, after my college, after this, I joined the Central Excise as an inspector, left that place because of the corruption they were involved in. I was not brought up that way. So I went to the Tatas. Tatas for 25 years I spent there in Tatas. I was a sports and I was a freelance sports writer. Having seen those writings in Hindustan Times, Amit Bazar Patrika, Statesman, the New Indian Express and so on, even Sports Star, I was moved to the education department. We had 25 schools there in Tata, sponsored by, run by the Tatas. As a senior education officer, then I came over here in 2000, after 25 years of service there. And all these things were possible because of Father Thambi. I remember while I was in the assembly, he called me. Has anybody read the newspaper today? Because Campion High School was written there. I won a bronze medal in the cross country. That was my first medal, way back. And from that day onwards, I got an. I accidentally ran for. I was not a runner. I ran that race, got the third place. And after that, my friends guided me, and I got into high jump. And high jump. So I was just a 51 kg person, but I used to beat the railways, the police, the army, everybody in the Tamil Nadu state, and reached that height and national medals. Every nationals I used to get waved back from 1971 to 76. I was at all the nationals. And Father Mathai was there for one of the nationals in Madurai. It was the Open National Athletics Championship. He was there. And he gave away the medals when I won. But I won the silver medal there. Hello. This is my background. And after that, I come over here. And it's so nice to see you all together here. I'd like to introduce my wife. Come on. She's been so supportive of me in those days. When I was looking after the family, the sports, because I have to tour a lot. Always. Even in college, I was never in college at all. Never in college. Always in the national camp at Patiala, Punjab. So that was the scene. And I used to come home late. Because I used to train people also. I trained an Asian Games gold medalist also, 800 meters, Charles Bromia. Pictures and interviews, people from all these media came to my house. And because he gave this name, this is the person who trained me. And it was a nice feeling. But now I'm there out of sports. I'm here at home and I have an institute. I run an IELTS academy here, training people in English for those people going to US, Australia, New Zealand, Canada, and UK. And nothing more I would like to say except for the great support my wife gives throughout everywhere. Even though she was ill, she always says, go on, you don't worry about me, be here, I'll look after you, don't worry. You go and look after his job. That is the way it is. Still we move on and I keep going. Thank you very much.
Got the gold medal in the 1980 games
at India. Yeah. Mrs. Indira Gandhi was there. N.G. Ramachandran
was
there.
I was there.
Just one.
Hello.
Yeah.
Just give one.
All is good.
I'm coming back to that. Regarding that Asian Games at Delhi 1982, Charles Bromia, while he ran the race, Mrs. Indira Gandhi was there and Mr. M.G. Ramachandran, Chief Minister of Tamil Nadu, was also in the front row when he completed that race. And they have promised him Padma Shri that time. Okay? Now, after that, he didn't get that Padma Shri. And my...
After that, he represented Andhra Pradesh for amount of money. That is why...
I'll tell you, because he is my close friend. I have photographs of the medal with my daughter and everything. It was me who wrote an article about the promises they have made. And I gave a full statement of those people who are not medalists in the Asian Games, who have got the Padma Shri. And the very next year, he was awarded the Padma Shri because of it. People in Tamil Nadu, the cutting which I have it also, with A. Napoleon there at the bottom. Then who is this Napoleon who takes the name of the Prime Minister and the Chief Minister? They never knew. I was in Bihar, in Jamshedpur. But he got that. He got that Padma Shri. Not because that I thought. My write-up was a big thing which had an effect on the media. Thank you.
Well done.
Hi everybody, I'm Frederick James, World by a Campion 69 set. I played football for the school. I played during my college studies. I played for Jamal 2 years, university in Ness, and on another subsequently. Then during school days, I used to skip practicing football. Edison, he used to stand outside the gate, catch me by my ear, go inside, go for practice. Then I became a very good football player. Then I did my BUC in St. Joseph's, BA in Jamal Mount College, and my physical education thing at Karikudi. Then I did my certificate course in NIS Bangalore, as well as Institute of Sports Bangalore. I joined a private concern. I was working there, and I'm retired now. My wife was a painting teacher. She is also a nurse. I have two kids. One daughter is married, another is waiting for marriage. And just a retired person. Thank you.
Before starting, I would like to thank those who have taken pains and those who have put efforts in making this a functional success. So, Meenachi Sundaram, Meenachi Sitaram, Manikam, Arun, Herman, and all those who have contributed for this session, I would like to thank them. Now, I would like to say about myself. After finishing my studies, I did my BA. In Hindi, because I took Tamil as a second language. So I have four children, three daughters and one son. My first elder daughter, she has completed a PhD. She is an associate professor in Lageja College in Mumbai. My son is working Deutsche Bank in Mumbai. Another, the two girls, they are also working in same university and they are postgraduates. And
what is problem for that?
So really what I do, I see how to get better. So how we are here today, we should be better tomorrow, or we should do helping others. So on page 27, I will read out what I written or note there. So two things I would like to say, that we should be attractive and pleasing. So we set up the vibrations, we should be attractive. So that is the meaning of Lord Rama. Here Rama means when who pleases and Krishna who attracts. So these the two qualities we should. And I have written one thing I would like to tell you, that when we speak, we should speak softly. We should speak softly, must not speak any harsh words, because that will have effect on the person who listens. So there's this quality we should develop. And secondly, when anyone talks, we should not interfere in between. So we should allow others to finish what they're trying to say. So if we talk in between what the other person is saying, we miss a lot of opportunities which lie in us, in the advice. And secondly, I would like to say that before going to bed, you can say that I am physically active and mentally relaxed. That will have a tremendous effect. So we should not think that we have become old, that we can't do any work, because as age, as we grow old, we just think that we are growing old, but it is not like the mind does not grow old. So we till the last day, we should be helpful to others. So I have read what I have written, page 27. So this is one paragraph I was asked by Meenachi and Manika. So this is a note I written. Actually, I would like to say the teachers did their job well. So when we were studying, the teachers did taught us very well. They out of dedication. But we in those days, what we know, we were not so mature. We didn't know the value of time. How much your parents. Before, one thing I would like to tell you, before getting admission to Campion, my mother took lots of pain. I was not getting admission because I was a non-IIT. was not an Anionian, but a Christian. So first preference was given to the Anionians and Christians. We Hindus never used to get it. But my mother had a dream that I had only one son. So, and I had elder brother, and he was very old. But her dream was that I should be educated in Campion. So daily we used to come here for many weeks, and finally I got a seat in Campion. So my dream, it was a memorable day how we got this. And for my son also, it was very difficult for us to get the seat. Now, not evident what we are today. See, generally when the teachers take the class, no, the students don't listen. They be talking among themselves and chatting. What is the value of the education? They didn't know that. And there were some students who used to just listen to the class. So I have written what we are today. It is because of their teachings and their dedication. They dedicated their life for us. Today I ask forgiveness from the beloved God. Now, if we say anything and all tomorrow, if we feel sorry, that we go and ask forgiveness. Sir, what I don't know, because we won't have peace of mind until we go and do the same thing, friendship with them. And today I ask forgiveness from our beloved God if he had misbehaved. The teacher, according to the situation, circumstances, used to work, isn't it? The teacher job is a difficult job. I can tell you, because there's some work for salary, for the need of money. This is very difficult, and I would not say any advice to, because all of you experience. But life has taught a lot of us. So as time passed, we know our difficulties, how we are today. So we ask forgiveness from our beloved God if we misbehave toward them, knowingly or unknowingly. Moreover, whatever knowledge we have, it should be dedicated for the benefit of others. So this knowledge, what we have taken from the society. So whenever I teach the children, my work is a teaching student, I tell them whatever you learn, it is for others you should learn, not for yourself. இது வந்து அடமான மாதிரி நம்ம வெளியில் வாங்கி உங்களுக்கு பேருக்கு கொடுக்கணும். For the development of India, for the development of our country, we should share our knowledge and we should do a work dedicated. And this opportunity what I got, I'm really happy in seeing all my old friends here and along with their families. It's nice to be here. So thank you.
I want to add a small thing about Lachan. Even now, he is so skilled to ride a 35 years old two-wheeler scooter. He's so great.
Lal Chan was sitting at the side of me in class day, class hours. He was my neighbor. So we had good fun. Next I call Mohammed Ali. Jinnah. Jinnah, come.
Sir, I'm going to photo.
I am Mohammed Ali Jinnah. I secured first class and max. I have secured 97% in the public examination. And after that, I joined Jamaa Ahmad College to complete my degree. And I worked in a 5-star hotel as a dancer for 5 years. I know Ajizula, he worked in Sangam Hotel. I am in Jenny's Bliss Residency. I know him very well. From the young kids, we work and we study only, and we join and we play in the evening time, and we will gather and do our work. I have got one son, he is a handsome boy. He has completed PE degree and he is working in American collaboration. limited company.
He's really
handsome. His J. Mohammed Asardin, his name. His B completed in Sarnathan College. Then I'm interested in writing poems. I wrote many poems. One of my poems I am going to recite now. Okay?
Good.
Okay.
Okay. To the north he goes in need of harlot and goes to spend the time as a healer. To the east he goes to satisfy his appetite and eats his meal after stealing all the night. To the west he goes in need of wealth and wastes all to comfort himself. To the south he goes in need of power and fame. Has he attained any gain in his game? Who knows man's exact need? Learn how to do good deeds. I can hear the voice of many crying that needs only money. The only need for man is 6 feet in the earth for his everlasting bed after his last breath. Now neither great victories nor awards will guard him, but good virtues and deeds will be rewarded in heaven.
Okay,
can
you control the small step of a dance?
No, I'm not interested now. That's all my teenage, young age.
We'll take you teenage, don't worry.
As we hotel, owner. Then what to say? I've got one daughter, two grandsons, and they are all engineers, and my daughter is a BBA. My son-in-law is engineer. He's trying about 1 lakh or 2.5 lakhs in Trichy. Then, now, thank you for giving me the opportunity.
Thank you, Mr.
Narayan.
Thank you, sir.
Lucky.
Hello, everybody.
Hello.
Is it audible? Okay.
Audible.
Audible. First of all, hello. Okay. Let me thank Manikam and Meenakshi Sundaram. Because of them, I'm here. Secondly, had Lal Chand given the speech before Napoleon, I wouldn't have interrupted Napoleon's speech.
No problem.
Yeah, he knows, he understood. Okay, secondly, I want to tell that I'm fortunate to have celebrating my second 50th reunion. The earlier one was in the March, which I celebrated in Chennai, Bishop Kauri High School. I studied up till 8th standard there and I joined Campion only in 9th. I remember very well my mother and father going for the pains that they took to join me in the school. Matthias was the principal then. Every day he used to deny them. Finally, he agreed.
You are a sweet boy, man.
And I'm sure, before I never used to speak anything, everybody knows it. Now I'm the other way. Anyhow, I have come from Jaipur. I've settled in Jaipur for more than 40 years. I'm a gemstone dealer there. Yeah, that's what I want to say. I will introduce my wife. Come. Manikam, I know him very well. My wife, Deepa Lakhi.
Gem of your life.
Now he's called to give a small speech.
Come.
He's late, but better late than never. And last, Ian will give his speech. We are waiting for you, Ian.
Nice to meet all of you. I'm Lance Roderick, one of the veterans there. I was one of the veterans there. Everybody knows that. I'm so happy that this interview is being conducted so that we can all so that we can all meet one another after 50 years. If all goes well, I think if God willing, we still live, we can meet even after another 50 years.
Yes.
I hope so. It's all left in God's hands. At least he has kept us so long. So we are thankful for that. Anyway, after I left the school, I went to Delhi, job hunting. Though I used to get selected, but I didn't know the language, the roads, because they asked me to, if I were able to ride a two-wheeler to know the roads, I didn't know all that. And I came back, and then I joined with BHL temporarily. After that, on the compassionate grounds, I joined the railway as a senior technician. That post I retired in 2010. From then, I've been in the RK department, rice killing department. Of course, my wife also is a teacher. She's a Malayali. Yeah, Kerala.
Mathavathiri.
So,
I'm
coming. I'm coming to the point. I'm having a daughter and a son. The daughter, I think, did an MA. She's married. I think a boy from Bodrum. But now she's working in Ooty. She's having two kids. So I think two grandchildren I'm having. And I'm having a son. He's now in Bangalore. He did his BBA. And he's working for Infosys. He's married now 2 years ago. And we were there for about 5 years. In Bangalore, looking for a girl for him. So many were offering me, but not for him. So that is why it was being postponed. Finally, God sent a girl. She's a VTech, no? Intech, and all that. And so he's living there. He's happy. We are also happy. So now we are doing engine and van. I have to say that because I was the railway, I returned the rail, so we are an agent and van, living alone. Some of we pass at time. Of course, we talk to our children every day, morning and night. Then there's nothing more to say. I'm very happy that this meeting was conducted and organized so well. I thank each and every one of you. Having made an opportunity to come here, but I'm sorry, I was late. I was the last because I had attended a mass at a different place. I couldn't get convinced. That's why I'm late. So I apologize for that. I give to my wife, she'll say just a few words.
He wants to escape.
Thanks a lot. For God, first I have to say thank you, Lord, because first time I'm meeting Lancey's friends and the families. So I am very happy. Today is the best day in my life.
Yes.
Because I don't know how was Lancey. Because I am going to meet all the friends and I am going to know about him. You have not told about them.
Lot of stories.
So tonight we will have a big fight in the house. God gave me a loving husband. So.
Lal Chand made a nice article rather, but if I am to give an article about myself, it will take pages and pages, maybe volumes like that. Because as you know, you all know, I was a veteran there. Up to all the mischief, you know that, you all know that. Anyway, I'm glad I met every one of you. I'm very happy. Let this continue after some time and not break. Because it took us 50 years to meet one another.
Let this group continue.
Sure, it will continue.
Yes.
Sure, it will
continue.
Let's
see.
You are
hitting
demand. Thank you, Rahman. And Rahman, Aziz, I can't forget all of you. No. Come to Ayyappanam. I got a house there. After in 2005, I purchased a house. I retired in 2010, but 2005 I purchased a house. First I was in Malapur, then I went to railway company, I got quarters. Then we moved in, yeah. So I thank each and every one of you for having given me this opportunity to say what I was able. Because if I continue, this meeting will not end. It will go on and on. So thank you. God bless each and every one. God bless.
Thank you, Lancey. I didn't expect it. I thought you would be homecoming.
You told me that you'll be coming late. So once again, I thank you, dear family. Welcome. Lalu, come. Lalu and Mrs. Lalu, come. Just take photo.
Ian, Mr. Ian, word to come. Welcome.
It's good afternoon, everybody. I made a special request to be last. The first thing I'd like to do is to... Sorry?
You are not the last.
No, last rather than the committee. Okay? Yes, my name is Ian Bird. I live now in Melbourne, Australia. One of the things I'd like to do is to really capitalize on the emotion within the team here. There are a number of things I do in my work life, and one of them is probably developing organizations and businesses. I'll give you a little bit more of my professional career in a minute, but one of them is actually celebrating. Whenever we do things in a business, I like to celebrate. So when Menakashi sent this email to me and invited me here, I could not but say yes. And I would like to thank the committee, irrespective of all the arrangements. I've been part of arranging many events in my life. It takes a lot of patience and a lot of time and sacrifice. So please put your hands together for the committee. Okay, that's the first thing I ask you to do. But when I rate that clapping out of 5, it's about a 2. So let's give them a real big round of applause. Thank you. Get into it. Thank you very much. One of the benefits that I see in my life is success. I think there are a lot of politicians, a lot of business people look around life today to try and identify success. For me personally, this room is full of success. Not a 1, that's not even a 2, a 5 clap. Applause for all of you. And as you've heard it today, our success as fathers, as parents, is very much subject to the help we get from our wives and our spouses. You're the one that needs a 10 clap. Okay, let's do it for that. Yeah. One of the things I learned in my early life as a professional is behind every successful man, there is a woman in front of him. Okay? The woman provides the leadership. I had pleasure in being here. My hometown is Melbourne, Australia. I've had a very exciting career. I would have to say it is even past my dreams. As a student of Campion, if I had to have the wildest, greatest dream in terms of my life, it would never have come close to my life. And I see that reflected in many of you. After I left Campion and finished in 1969, my family immigrated to Australia in June of 1970. And from there, my life of a different nature began. In Australia, it's a very independent life. You have to basically develop yourself. I was successful in getting a cadet engineering ship with a multinational company. And that caused me to go to night school, to university, 3 nights a week for 12 hours, 4 hours a night. 1.5 day, the company gave me time to go to university, and I had to work for 3.5 days within the company. It was a cadetship. I could not pay my bills. I could not, because when we went, we all worked and lived independently. So I had to get a part-time job. I worked as a waiter in one of the top clubs in Melbourne, serving drinks and food to people. On Saturdays, I worked in a men's store selling menswear. I had a lot of entertainment and fun fitting people out with their gear. So I did this for about 7 years, 7 to 8 years to get my qualifications in engineering before I actually said to myself, I'm not going to commit to a lady in my life till I finished my studies. It was a heavy commitment. The only day I had to myself was Sunday. And part of this commitment in terms of study and work has come from the discipline and the work ethic from Campion. It was about that time I met my darling wife, Annie. Come on. Anne is from, would you like to speak or would you like me to introduce you? Okay. My wife is born in Australia. She has parents from Slovenia. We're between Austria and Italy. They came to Australia after the Second World War. So they were immigrants into Australia. And they had a very humble beginning. One of the greatest people in my life has been her father. And it just so happens today, without reminding you, today is his anniversary. Okay? Incredible. Okay? And we are here. So I met my wife, we were dating for a couple of years, and I just finished my education, and I was awarded an international scholarship. And the opportunity came up for me to go and work in the US. So I took my wife, we got married, within 6 months of marrying, and she lived at home all her life. And her parents were not happy that I took her with me, away from the family, to live in the US. This was back in the days before technology, etc. This was in 1978. So I worked in the US as an engineer, and I had a chance to have great experiences of traveling and working across many of the states. I've had a chance to live and work in 43 of their 50 states. So when you look at a map of the US, I've been able to travel from coast to coast. I worked for the company called Cadillac Motor Company, who makes Cadillac vehicles. So everywhere I traveled, I had a Cadillac vehicle. That was a very good, exciting time. On the way back, I brought Anne here to Campion. That was in 1981. So that's the first time she came to see Campion. We went back home, we put our family on hold, we went back home. One of the hobbies I picked up is actually designing and building my own homes. Her dad taught me how to do that. We built our first home, and then we had our first child. I have two great children. I have a son, David, and I have a daughter, Renee. David's an engineer, and it so happens that he comes to India quite often with his, he looks after Asia Pacific in one of the vehicle platforms. My daughter is a primary school teacher, and she teaches in a local Catholic school and has been for over 10 years. I'm very blessed with two great close family children, and from them, we are blessed with four granddaughters. I come from a family of four boys. Three of them came to Campion: Kellen Bird, Christopher Bird, and Ian Bird. I have a younger brother, Keith, who unfortunately was too young to come to Campion. So we have four granddaughters. We have a very strong work ethic in our family. My wife travels about an hour and a half to help my son look after two of our granddaughters while he and his wife work. That's for 2 days a week. The other 2 days a week, she's looking after my daughter's grandchildren for the same thing. We do not talk about retirement. One of the activities that we've had that have been part of our life is to actually take our families and live in other countries. Back in the mid-90s, my wife had enough of me traveling. I used to travel and work for 26 weeks of the year. And I said, listen, they've offered me an appointment to take on a position in Thailand. She said, I'll go anywhere so long as you don't travel. So we took my family, my children, and we went and established our life in Thailand. We were there for over 3 years. My role was to convert a pineapple plantation into a car manufacturing plant. Through all of these times, we've had the privilege and the opportunity to travel across many parts of the world. We've seen many things that I would like to have thought about in school, let alone wanted to do. We've been to India a few times as a family. I brought my children here to Campion. They have seen Campion. They've experienced the discipline from the brothers at that time to see how they were. So we've had a lot of good things to happen. Back about 15 years ago, my wife was tired of my traveling, and they appointed me to take on a position in Japan, and then it was China, and she said, I hope you're going to have a good time because I'm staying home. Okay? So it was time for me to leave corporate life. I left corporate life and I started my own company. For the last 15 years, I helped develop companies around the world. one of the great opportunities I have is developing companies in India. I develop partnerships between Australian companies and Indian companies. And at this point in time, in the midst of about 8 different partnerships. I have some long-standing partnerships with people in the north, very honorable businesses, and I'm very supportive of all of them. When I go back to Australia, there are going to be a couple of Indian company owners that are going to be traveling there to meet me and to some other partners. So I do not see an opportunity for retirement. For me personally, old age starts at 90, okay? Middle age is all the way to 90. And that's why God gives us the courage and the support to do what we're doing, and if we enjoy it, that is great. I'm very blessed. I'm very blessed. What Campion started in my life and has helped continue to keep me on the straight and narrow and make sure. One of the blessings that we have is that we share a very strong faith in God. Our life is spent doing 3 things, very similar to all of you: work, family, and our spiritual side, our religion. Soon I'm going to find some time to do the 4th thing, and that's to do something for us to enjoy. It has been a pleasure. I'll get to know most of you, bringing back memories. I do have a small challenge, and I would like to see anybody that follows it, is to find me in that photograph. Okay? You don't even start to have to look at the faces. You can start with the names. And there's a story behind it. I'm not in that picture. Okay? If you look at it, I'm not the big, I was away at a state cricket tournament at that time when the picture was taken. So it just brought back memories. And for all my life, I've been trying to look for this picture because I knew I did not have any knowledge of it. But I can assure you, I was definitely a class of 69.
Yes.
Thank you very much.
Thank you, Ian. It's my turn now. My name is Ram Ratnam. They call me Chino. And I'm very glad to be here, and I'm also glad all of you are here. Okay, let me make it short and sweet because time is running out. Okay, after I left Campion in 1969, I studied PUC in St. Joseph's. I did my BCom in St. Joseph's. And afterwards, I did 1 year of catering. And then I left for US to do my MBA. And after finishing my MBA, I worked for there for 1 year. And totally I spent about 5.5 years there. And then I returned back to help my father in his business. We are hoteliers basically. And I took over the hotel, HP Hotel it's called. And I managed it for 35 years. Now, managed it for 35 years, and after that, you know, I was kind of getting tired or old or thing. I just want to spend some time for myself and my family, so I retired, and now I'm relaxing. Okay, I'm looking for more get-togethers like this, weddings, all these kind of things, okay. And that's where I stand right now. I have, my wife has not come this afternoon, she'll be coming in the evening. I have a son and a daughter. My daughter is married and she settled in Kanjipuram. My son, he's a logistic man. He's in Dubai. And that's my story. I stay in Trichy, Tilinagar. And all of you are welcome to my home whenever you visit Trichy. Okay. Anything you want to know, please ask me.
Thank you.
Thank you very much.
Thank you. Dear ladies and friends, first of all, I want to thank all of you for making this a function a great success. Because without you, this function would not have happened. Right. Sir, please come to the stage. she will talk about our family. By the time she comes, I want to say a few words about myself. After schooling, what to say, from 6th standard to 11th standard, I was the monitor. And one big thing is in 1970-71, among the 9 sections in PUC, 8 people were from Campion, all were monitors. So that gives a big pride in St. Joseph's College that Campion boys are always monitors.
Leaders.
Okay. Then, after death of my father, I came to Trichy and my wife was with me to do all my things. She looked after the family, but I went to the service because I represented my association, my business, because of my business, and where all the services where I am doing, I hold all the big position and retired, and I am advisor in 5 service organizations. She will talk about my family.
We have a son and a daughter.
Tell about yourself.
I am a homemaker. I am also from Trichy. I studied in St. Joseph's Convent and later Holy Cross. Morning I came to know that Ruby's brother is, I was very happy to know about it. Later about our children, one son and one daughter, both married and both have kids of their own. Both earlier they were in US, now they are at Bangalore. Actually, we are all retired and taking care of the grandchildren, enjoying with them. That is my thing.
Thank you.
Thank you.
And we'll go in for lunch.
Evening, it's going to be in the poolside. I want all of you to think about something that happened in Campion concerning you. Something nice. Okay, concerning you, and which has stood in your heart for this long. Okay, recall something. I'm just telling you this in advance so that you can think about it. Okay.
What time do we meet? What time?
7 to 7:30.
7:30.
Okay. Okay. We start at 5 with tea. Okay, tea and snacks. And then proceed, there are some games for the ladies and the children. And after that, you know, we join to get together and we do the honors. Yes. And in between, we'd like you to come and tell us about your experience in Campion. Some particular experience you made, experience whether you get beaten or you got... whether you smoked and got caught. Or something like that, you know, you bunk class and went for the movies. I'll tell you all, and each of you, I would like to come up with something which will be interesting for the others to hear. Thank you.
Ladies, first you go for lunch, then gents will come. But if this meeting was arranged by male, Meenakshi Sundaram is not here. The sad dimension. Because it was my father-in-law's device, he left the thing. So really, we are not... I feel very sad for that. Okay, so ladies first for the...
I request everybody to assemble here by 5 p.m. so that we can have a great time. From 5, we start with the games and everything and all those things. So please come at 5 p.m. 5 p.m.
We meet at the poolside.
You know, from here and then we'll, from here we'll move to this side. First we come here,
we're going to have some tea, and then we go to
games and everything.
The food will not be hampered. It's for the
Yeah, the winner has come.
kung fu lord.
Thank you.
Napoleon. Today we are all, whether we are seniors or juniors, it's not the question. We are all Campionites. We belong to one family, isn't it?
Yes.
So first, I like to start with a game. Please form a team with your family.
Yeah, that's a big question. It's a big job.
And those who have come, those who are alone, single.
Couples.
This is a game for the family. No, this is not Tambola. First we start with the family game. Please form a group with the family, and those who have come alone, I would like them to make a team. It's a team game, so we can have a team effort.
How many is the team?
Two or three,
no problem. It's a team, the effort of a team. Now, Sidharaman, I would like you to help me, assist me in this. I will explain the game. It was like going back to school. Okay? The name of the game is, I'll give you newspapers, a bottle of gum, and also a blade. Be careful when you handle the blade. I will give you also a paper, examination paper. You have to make cuttings from the newspaper and make the most humorous headlines and paste it on the paper. Instead of writing, you have to paste it. The conditions are that you must not cut a word into two. You have to cut one full word or one full sentence. Make your own sentences, but don't cut any full sentence into two parts. You can make 10 humorous headlines. Whoever makes the most maximum headlines, we will judge them and give them a good prize. So this will involve the entire team. Okay, how many teams are there?
Team 1.
Team 2.
Team 3. Team 4. Team 5, 6, 7. No problem. The entire family can go. So 7 teams are there. You give them the blades later. It's a team effort. That team has to make sentences.
Consists of how many members?
Family. Four members. Three members.
Four or three, not five.
Four. 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 Four.
Four. Four.
Four. Four. Four. Four. Four. Four. Four. Four. Four. Four. Four. Four. Four. Four. Four. Four. Four. Four. Four. Four. Four. Four. Four. Four.
Thank you.
sir. Blade. Blade. Be careful with the blade.
It's like this. Please make your own newspaper name. On the top, please make your own. Please make your own name. And you can write like this the name of the newspaper. And then make numerous headlines. You have to share with you this thing of faith and this share. Okay, come to what you have done. For example, we can always say Sonia Gandhi elopes with Modi. Just a joke.
Newspaper buckle is well.
See, just a humorous headline like Sonia Gandhi loves with Modi. Something funny. It's left to your imagination. How wide your imagination goes. How creative it is. Yes, yes, you can take a sentence from anywhere. Yes, yes. That's why I'm giving you a blade also, you can take a sentence. But only things, a bird should not be split into two. You want a newspaper? Yeah. For those who don't have gum, please take a saucer from him and take the gum from the bottle here. The tube. This is the only exam where coughing is allowed and consultation is allowed. See, we have all gone through so many exams. The teacher walks down, no talking, no coughing.
I am
the
examiner.
He is the examiner, not the examiner, he will also assist you. I see all the newspapers of 2017. So use your imagination.
Any time, even.
I'll give you 15 minutes time.
Kethan Porta. Kethan Porta.
Now, Panada Porta.
Chess.
10 headlines, 1 newspaper name.
Vian, be careful, don't cut the chair. We have to pay the fine.
You are remembering the classroom days?
Yes.
How well he is remembering the school days. That's a spirit.
What about play? What, Jack? What happened? You are reading the newspaper, huh?
Yes.
Huh? They are reading the subject very well before answering.
Pens.
No, name is not necessary. From the name of the newspaper, I can find out who's who.
Okay.
Let the name be secret. I hope you are all aware of the rules. And those who have a pen, it's okay. If not, we will give you a toothpick to make a hole in the number when I call out the number. And as I call the number, any five in one straight line, the prizes will be one straight line, any line, all the three lines will get a prize. All the three horizontal lines, not vertical lines. Five numbers should be there. Then a full house. Then we have a second full house. So these are the, there will be five prizes and first number is number four.
What's the houses?
I told you the houses are any straight line, full house and second full house. The first number on the card board is number four. Second number is 26. Again, minus 3, 23.
Yeah.
That's a bogey if you come here. You said, yeah, you created a heartbreak in a pulse repair going faster. This is number 7. Lucky number 7. Now the 5th number. Anybody getting a straight line, the 5 numbers will get a prize. Now 7 and 4, 74. 74. Nobody is of that age here, I think so. 74. The last of the teens. Last of the teens. Tell me. 19. Four and three. 43. Maybe my waistline, 43. Five and seven. 57. 2 dozens. 2 and 4, 24. 7 and 2, 72. Somebody's weight is 72 kilos. All these sevens, double seven. Still no straight line. 5 and 6, 56. Four and five. 45? 45. That's the midway number. 6 and 4. 64. What happened? No call yet. 2 and 0. 20.
Yeah.
Yeah. Okay, I will give you the numbers. So please give the tickets, Manikam. I will repeat the numbers. Okay. I want to give an equal opportunity to everybody. And those who have missed any number?
Second chance.
Second chance to rewrite your paper. Okay, shall I start with the numbers? Number 4, number 7, number 19, number 20, 23, 24, 26, 43, 45, 56, 57, 64, 72, 74, and 77. Shall I go ahead?
Yeah.
Again, 15. 1 and 5, 15. Number 5. Single number 5. A pair of hockey sticks. Number 11. Hockey was a very popular game in Campion. Campionites used to win it always. Again, State Express. A non-smoker's zone here. Double 5. 55. Everybody likes chicken 65. 65.
6 and 5, 65. 8 and 7, 87. When we were all bachelors, 12. 5 and 8, 58. 58 plus 10, 68. 7 and 1, 71. 75, mukkal century. 5 and 3, 53. 3.
Number 10.
Yes. See, everybody remembers the address, Downing Street. Number 10. 14. 1 and 4. Inachi, no. Huh? Not Jaldi Pai, any straight line. No Jaldi Pai. Now it is Sri Devi's age, permanent age. What is Sri Devi's permanent age? 16. See, everybody remembers Sri Devi. Sweet 16. Padinaar Vayadhi Nile. Seven and six. 76. Sitaraman Sirikirare. Naa Sollala Nalla Vela Tarchitain. Sri Devi Pati Solirundarnaka. Enna Irukum?
Yes.
So third line is over. Now the middle line, the top line, and the full house. You can take the ticket, Naran. You can try for the full house.
One second full house.
In Tamil language, you know what it is. So the first full house, people tear the tickets. Second chance for a full house. Yeah, there he comes. See, that book, I don't get on that. 3 and 7, 37. So the middle line, top line, and two full houses. 5 and 9, 59. 7 and 9, 79. 6 and 3. I put the order. 6 and 3, 63. 8 and 4, 84. No. Here's in which all numbers you finding out. All the fours. Big formula 44. I hope you remember the top mixture and the tablet. 44. Any line?
Yes. Missed it.
Okay. Single number 2. 3 and 8. 38. You got it? 38 should be there. What line?
Second line.
Middle line. Second line is gone. 18. 38. 53, yes, it is there.
Yeah.
And 68 is there.
Yes.
And 80
is there.
Yeah. So please give a big hand to the child who's got that. Four and seven, 47. India got independence in 47. First line. Yeah.
Only the full houses
are left. Number 4. Number 4 is our family going to
praise
our day.
Full house.
3, yes.
35.
35, yes.
43.
43, yes.
64.
64, yes.
70.
70, yes.
14.
14, yes.
39.
39, yes.
53.
53, yes.
68.
68, yes.
81.
81, yes. 81, what is it? 81,
if last has only 81.
Last has only
81 Number 2.
Number 28. Number 30.
Number 30.
Number 34.
Number 34.
Number 42.
Number 42.
Number 44.
44.
Number 52.
52.
56.
56.
Number 60.
60, yes.
Number 66.
66, yes.
Number 71.
Number 71, yes.
Number 77.
77.
Number 88.
88, yes.
Third floor.
Second floor.
Second
floor.
Sir, she's got also the online, no? Give the online also right now.
I need to wait for the phone.
Give her
perfect. Okay.
Thank
you.
Sir, sir. Third floor is rent pair.
Sir?
Sir?
Sir? All looking at the camera.
Okay. Great. Where
thank you.
Line. This is a spectacle folder. Kannadi vekkira.
My wife from all along Australia. Come on. I get a special invite.
Yeah. Especially for Neelin now.
Yeah.
Sir. Sir.
Thank you. We're the winners.
Endless reasons to shop. That's the first headline. And relations get better with time in high spirits. When we are in high spirits, the relationship becomes better.
Yes.
Raja did not ignore PM or FM says quote. The brain behind the deadline, it was not Raja. Reading Rahul Gandhi's hand, missing the pulse. Tendulkar makes a public speech, Asian paints to boost capacity. The truth is out on 26, says Rahul Gandhi, the game that stops the world. We can carry the confidence to South Africa, only biryani. President Govind to arrive in Tamil Nadu today, dare to thread anywhere. Panel 6 details from Apollo Sashikala, New Year special discount sale at Apollo Hospital. That is one line. You all tell me later on which is the best line. I'll give three prizes totally for that. One is Trump campaigning in RK Nagar. US calls India doping cloud. Modi's winning Sunny Leon. Modi's bachelor's days will go away. Modi jit, taste of victory. Bridesmen and groom. Prisoner pay extra. Free DMAT account. Doorway of the gods.
Oh.
Adi na adi pudusa irukku. Then safety getting ends in
Best bikes.
Matters.
matches. The next one is indoor editorial, Indian editorial. Rajini fans cleaning up school toilet. Swachh Bharat. 9 PFOL to get political entry.
9 PFOL.
No, PFOL. PFOL. Taxpayers die of aspiration. The big flops, US peace plan. Naveen Patnaik to bite Lalu. Jaitley ignored fishermen. Rahul poses serious health hazard. Weak banks may increase asylum seekers. DGP Jacob Thomas suspends Jaya in hospital. She is already in suspended animation only. Rahul raped Mamta inside Odisha College. Yadapadi OPS held for women's murder near Dindigul.
Eating love of openness.
Santa Claus hasn't yet.
Father, very well, I want to just chat. When we are feeling hungry, we used to go and ask him, Father, we are feeling hungry, what should we say? Okay, you go and buy kadal mutai and cocoa mutai. So important. Another one says, it's very hard, Father, I couldn't eat. So what do you want? I want only groundnut. Okay, go and get groundnut. Like that, another one asked for mango. Sita, go and buy mango. Like that, he was satisfied each and everybody at running like anything. But you know what's the cost? Mango costs 1 rupee. A chocolate costs 5 paisa. Father, I don't have paisa. Okay, you go. So he was so generous. If you ask, you will get it. So Father Miracle was so kind to us. In whatever you ask, we got it.
Okay. I think the hostlers will know about this. Once, I think in 68 or 67, not 67, I think.
68.
We wanted to go for a film in the night. So, you know, third floor. We climbed down the pipe, went for the movie. I think Love in Tokyo. Love in Tokyo, I think, the movie's name. When we came back, all our pillows were missing. The pillows were in Merrifield's room. In Father Merrifield's room. So next day, we went to collect the pillows from him, and we had help from him anyway. I think Chidharam Hall was all right. Second instance, it's not too good, I'll just say. You know, we were hostlers. The senior hostlers had a small bungalow, as I said, in the morning. You know. It's next to the road. So what we normally do is, you know, this Holy Cross girls will be walking by. So we just stand there and just take it. So we used to make fun of them. Then we saw one nice lady walking by, coming by. So we all were making fun of her. The best joke was, when she came near, we realized she was Mr. Denison's wife. Mr. Denison, whose name was said on so many occasions today by Herman Johnson and Napoleon and all. Then what did we do? We all ran away, okay? She couldn't identify us. The only mistake we made was this Sardarji was there.
Ranjit
Singh, the turban. So she went and told her husband. No, these hostel boys were there. So I was supposed to be hostel captain. He called me and said, "What are you doing? You are going to study? You are going to study? Sir. Hey, and the bunch of people are there. Where's the Singh fellow? The Singh is in the hostel, right? Oh yeah, he's in the hostel, yes. Then he gave me a tight strap, my glasses all flew, you know. He had no other choice. And it was really hilarious because he called the entire hostel boys were called to stand before him and said, next time you all do this to my wife. But he just said, don't do it to my wife. He didn't say, you should not do to others. So we strictly complied with these regulations. So those two instances I can say about our stay in Campion, you know.
Thank you very much, Jalan.
Hostlers, come and tell. So many.
Mr. Arun.
For you.
Humorous.
Come on,
all right.
Very nice. Humorous headlines. We give the first prize to Mr.
Chosen by my wife. She must come in.
Yeah. Next prize goes to again their neighbors.
Oh, Sita Raman. Mr. Sita Raman.
No more.
Okay.
Thank you.
And the third prize goes to Raman.
How many Raman put up here? Come on, get it. Tony.
Yes.
Oh, Baba, only that's all.
Okay.
Studied 11 years in Campion.
But it was one Monday when we had the assembly. Father Thambi was there. He just spoke to the students there. Have you read today's paper, sports column? And everybody was fired. One of our students has done our school crowd. Then he taught Napoleon. He has won the bronze medal in the state level cross country race. And Campion High School name has come out there in the papers. Where is Napoleon? I was there, I put up my hand, and he called me, come here. When I came there, I was wearing my tie, but chappals here. Quietly, he bent down, he saw, and he told, meet me at 3:45 this evening. Okay, that was it. And exactly at 3:45, Benji came, Napoleon, yes, I live it. When I went there, he was ready with his
cane.
Vendors, we are supposed to get
gold medal.
Vendors, all. And I got three. And three tight benders, and I was stuck. We'll have to hold his wrist. If we leave the wrist, we get one more extra. I held it tight, and he gave me. And I started crying also. Mucus coming down here, my pants going down, and he was pulling it up. And he called Benji again, going by a belt for him from Watakada. He bought me a belt, then he had his Malaysian, he had a piece of cake there, he gave it. Sit out there, eat, and don't go there to a class. You run away from this place. I don't want you to share the cake. I just remember that and I wanted to share. Thank you.
The food was not good. So we all kept quiet. And somewhere about 10:30 we were studying for preparing for our exam, but we felt hungry. So nearly all the 11th standard students jumped that compound wall and went to a nearby hotel where this appam and pattani urugai and pattani sambar was available. Only that was because we were too late. So whatever we had, but we wanted to take it. Then the man said, no, no, you please wait, I will get you paratha and some sauce or something. Okay, we waited. But we were worrying whether we will get caught by the warden. So we ate only the appam and pattani kurma and paratha, we brought it to the hostel. We were so high pulling each one. We made a little bit fuss about it. Hearing the noise, warden came up. When he came up, we all went and closed the paratha and all those things. Hey, what are you doing? No, no, brother, we are feeling angry. So what is what? So see, in the night, 10 o'clock, 11 o'clock, we are eating paratha. What happened to your dinner? Did you eat your dinner or not? So he was shouting it. Then later on, hey, Sita, what is this? No, father, I was saying, okay, hereafter, whatever it is, you finish early. Don't eat in the late hours. Go to bed. Throw all the things. So we threw all the food and we went to bed. We came up top floor one time.
You all remember, whenever we finish a period test, Benji carries a big mark
sheet.
Big, huge. So he comes around and says, if the person has failed in 2-3 subjects, he never calls. If he fails in just one subject, he calls. He'll be sitting on the platform, everyone knows. And he make us Padmanabhan, RS. He just showed me the marks. I passed in every paper, but I didn't pass in maths, other case. He said, you go outside, you buy mangoes from the old lady. She knows, you give 1 rupee me.
Station of the second class boarders here.
No,
not too many, but I just have to say there were many times, especially during Father Macedo's time. I think Herman can back me up. I do not know where people got these things, but everybody will go to bed. Bedtime, everybody's asleep. And then all of a sudden, the marbles start to bounce. Start to bounce the marbles all around the place. And Father Macedo didn't know who did it and who didn't, so he'll come out and sweep the torch. Everybody's fast asleep. He goes back into his room, more marbles coming. And that was really the rehearsal, because it got a bit more serious. And maybe it brings back some memories that people don't really like to have, but I think you may realize that the plumbing systems went where they are today. And we used to have to use these little cans of water to go into the toilets. Some nights, the guys used to bring them and replace the marbles with the tin cans, okay? Can you imagine the noise that they make all the way down? And all of this was really to get the priests uptight and try to put some pressure on them. And one day, it got too much with him. And he actually switched the lights on and he came out with a cane and he gave everyone away. Absolutely. He didn't care who was guilty or not guilty, who was asleep or not asleep, lights came on and everybody got it. The thing that I'd like to actually say very quickly, the learnings that we have from our times is that I think we had a very good understanding what discipline was. Our parents brought us into the school to actually help us learn right from wrong. How many of you have been to the new principal's area, the new office area? I was very impressed to read Abraham Lincoln's instructions to the headmaster or the teacher when he was sending his child, his son, to the school. It's something that if you haven't read this, I'm sure you can go on the internet. This is in very big print right up on a mural in one of the walls in there. And it really probably reflects everything that our parents would wanted us to have in terms of education, in terms of schooling. And also, what I take away is life skills. We had to have life skills. We had to survive the world that we have today. And there is a proverb that sticks in my mind that I try to reflect on in my role as a parent of my children. And I think you need to listen to this very carefully. There's many a challenge that we have as parents to try to make sure that we prepare the road for them, to try and make the road smooth for them so that their life is not so difficult. You compare that perhaps to the other side, is to prepare your children for whatever road they take. Because we know we cannot always be there to make the road smooth. So rather than worry about creating the road, is to prepare our children for irrespective whatever the conditions of the road are. And that's a challenge that we all have as parents and as grandparents. And that's something that sticks into my mind. I'll ask my wife, she's been very quiet, she's come a long way, to say a few things about being married to a boy from Campion. Come on.
I didn't expect this. I just know Ian for so many years. I think he's a man of great integrity. He's honest, truthful, a wonderful father, granddad, and I'm so pleased that I'm here with him. I'm pleased that he's met up with all of you. I think he's extremely emotional about being here because I was talking to another lady earlier, and she was saying how her husband, she was just watching him on the balcony, taking in the school, how it's changed, and how his life has brought him to this stage. So I feel the same thing about him, because that's what I saw when I was here a few years ago. And I think he's turned out to be a great person, and I'm very proud of him, and I think all of you have turned out to be great people. I might not be in your culture, but you're all fantastic. I think I've learned a lot just listening to you all today and how wonderful you all are. So you really are great, and I just think it's a different culture, but we're all one. I think you're fantastic, so God bless you all.
Thank you.
Anybody else would like to share? Hello to everybody. She has always supported me everywhere.
Hello, everybody.
Yeah, yeah.
Hello, everybody.
Say hello to everybody.
Good evening. How are you all?
Fine.
I'm also good. Nice to see all of you. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Kavita, would you like to share some thoughts?
Good evening, everybody. As you all know, I'm Kavita, daughter of Manikam. So the preparation has been going for the past 3-4 months, and which has made my father really excited, and he's gone back to his school days. And after surviving this, you know, first attack, I have never seen him so enthusiastic and energetic except for these few months past. So I would like to thank everybody. He was expecting each and every person here. He was calling and was talking to them. And he was sharing about all nostalgic memories, everything. So to me, it is a very special occasion because I could see my father becoming like a child again. Again, he's gone back to all those things and very meticulously planning everything. Apart from that, I've taken cues from everybody today. Edo or vishyam, nalla vishyam, everything. From everybody could hear and tips on parenting, or how to face life, how things have changed in school, and another 50 years, how everybody have changed a lot, or evolved and been successful. What is success is quite a different question, but still I could see many happy faces, and a sense of accomplishment is there. So all those things are really, in the mid 40s, this is something really nice to hear, and nice to know also. So thank you very much for this opportunity, and I welcome everybody to our home. Please do visit our home whenever you come to Trichy. So that's it. Thank you so much.
Thank you, Kavita.
Because 50 years pass, okay, and it's unimaginable that we are able to meet up again, not having met for the last 50 years. Maybe only about 3 or 4 of us would have met now and then. Well, when this meet was arranged, there was a film called 96 which came up last year. Here the film 96 is about traveling back, thinking about the school days. So my wife used to say, this 96 movie makes you all do the 69 meet together, is it? I said, no, that's all, it's a co-education school. You are all boys school, But later did she know that what it was Cornwall just around the road. Then we kept on the secret, you see?
That's what we are trying to
do. So it's nice to see, right down south Australia, north Jaipur, Delhi, Bangalore, all over the place, meeting here. It's extremely unique, as what Ian Boyd was telling me. It's highly unlikely any other school would have done this. As a 50 years school going giving meet. Normally doing for universities and for colleges, but not for school. I think even brother was shocked today when he told me, the brother principal, he told me, it's very, 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 what do you call, strange that you have done it. Hope as a lecturer, teacher, or principal. So I would say, this idea was shown by Herman Johnson,
and picked up by Meenakshi Sundaram as the master. Meenakshi Sundaram gave his life and soul for this, together with his wife. So I think the first thing should go to him and his wife. Because they've done a lot.
Yes, yes.
And now he gave him a helping hand. That's what Manikam used to say. He was doing a job, I was just lifting things and giving it to him, that's all. So, it's very unfortunate he's not here, but it's in our minds.
Meenakshi and Manikam were inseparable partners in this.
They meet so often.
We were very happy to leave them, no? Like, they were like husband and wife working.
So here, I think we have, there's no need to say thanks because it's all of us have got together. So by saying thanks, actually we are just thanking each other. Okay, there's no one person. It's not like a very wedding ceremony or whatever, some other Rotary or Lions Club function saying thanks for you all to come. And Chino is always as usual, as late as ever. You know, he comes just in time for dinner. Morning, Chino's wife was not here. Let him introduce his wife first before we continue.
This is Mr. Chino. We used to call Chino, but his name is Ramaratnam. Ramaratnam. He belongs to a very big family. His grandfather was T.M. Narayan Sampradi, Vice Chancellor of Annamalai University. We come from a very good family. He got an Ashby Hotel, very big business around. And we got his daughter Nari. That's his wife. Okay, I give my mic to you.
First, let me apologize for being late. Okay, in the morning I couldn't bring her because we had some guests at home. And this is my wife, Sujarita. We've been married 37 years. Good. Thank you.
Sir?
Yeah. So I think we'll adjourn now to dinner, which is near the poolside, right?
Yes.
Dinner is near the poolside. And as usual, fellowship continues.
Yes.
So because some of them are catching a train early, so we have to meet them, have early dinner and send them home. Okay. Thank you, everybody. Thank you.
Thank you.